Hello guys, I am here today to talk about the life and times of Swami Vivekananda. Before I get into the video, I just want to say that I will not be covering his philosophical teachings, as it would be too vast for me to cover in just one video. So without much ado, let's get into the video. Swami Vivekananda was born as Narendranath Datta on the 12th of January 1863 at 3 Gormohan Mukherjee Street in Calcutta. The name Vivekananda was later suggested by Raja Ajit Singh of Khetri. Vivekananda means the bliss of wisdom, from the Sanskrit words Vivek and Ananda. Swami Vivekananda's father's name was Vishwanath Datta. He was an attorney. His mother's name was Bhuvaneshwari Devi. Vivekananda was the chief disciple of the mystic Lord Ramakrishna. He was instrumental in introducing Vedanta philosophy and yoga to the Western world. He is also responsible for the introduction of Hinduism as a major world religion in the late 19th century. He is also credited for founding the Ramakrishna Math and Ramakrishna Mission. Let us now talk about his academic achievements and educational qualifications. When he was little, the Swami attended the Metropolitan Institution from 1871 to 1877. When he grew up, he attended the Presidency College. There, he was the only student to receive first division marks. He studied a diverse range of subjects, from the Vedas and Upanishads to Indian classical music, to Western philosophy and history. He also had a degree in the fine arts. Needless to say, the Swami was a very well-read scholar. So impressed was his principal, Mr. William Histie, that he said about the Swami, "Narendra is really a genius. I have traveled far and wide, but I have never come across a lad of his talents and possibilities, even in German universities, among philosophical students. He is bound to make his mark in life." Some accounts have also called the Swami a Shrutidhara. A Shrutidhara is a person with immense and prodigious memory. In one of his talks, he once quoted from memory two or three pages from the Pickwick Papers. The Pickwick Papers is a novel by Charles Dickens. He could easily memorize poems from one or two readings also. Now let us talk a bit about his life with Lord Ramakrishna, who was the biggest influence in his life. He first met with Lord Ramakrishna in 1888. He initially viewed Ramakrishna's ecstasies and visions as mere figments of imagination. He also opposed idol worship, polytheism, and Ramakrishna's worship of the goddess Kali. The Swami's family at this point had been ravaged by financial difficulties due to the death of his father. Hence, one day, Swami Vivekananda asked Lord Ramakrishna to pray to the goddess Kali for the family's financial well-being. Ramakrishna advised the Swami to go to the temple himself and pray. Following the advice, he went to the temple thrice, but failed to pray for any kind of worldly necessities and ultimately prayed for true knowledge and devotions from the goddess. Narendra gradually renounced everything for God and accepted Ramakrishna as his guru. Sadly, in 1885, Lord Ramakrishna developed throat cancer and was transferred to Calcutta and later to Kosipur. The Swami and Ramakrishna's other disciples took care of him during his last days. He was taught that the service of men was the most effective worship of God. Ramakrishna asked him to care for the other monastic disciples and in turn asked them to see the Swami as their leader. Lord Ramakrishna died on the 16th of August, 1886. After Ramakrishna's death, the devotees stopped supporting his disciples, resulting in unpaid rent and abandonment by many of the order. The Swami then decided to convert a dilapidated house at Badanagar into a new mutt for the remainder of the disciples. Rent for the mutt was raised by Madhukari, which means holy begging. This was the first building of the Ramakrishna mutt. The Swami travelled a lot during his life. In 1888, the Swami left the monastery as a Parivrajaka, the Hindu religious life of a wandering monk, with his water pot, his staff, the Bhagavad Gita, and the Intimation of Christ, his two favorite books. He traveled extensively in India for 5 years, visiting centers of learning and acquainting himself with diverse socio-religious traditions. He saw the suffering and poverty of the people and resolved to uplift their life. He lived primarily on alms and traveled on foot and also railways, the tickets of which were bought by his followers. During his travels, he stayed with Indians from all regions and walks of life. The Swami's journey to the West started with visits to Japanese cities including Nagasaki, Kobe, Yokohama, Kyoto, Osaka, and Tokyo. He also visited China and Canada. While going to the United States, he reached Chicago on the 30th July 1893, where the Parliament of Religions was going to take place during September of the same year. At the event, Vivekananda started his speech with the words, "Sisters and Brothers of America," at which he received a 2-minute standing ovation from a crowd of 7,000. Vivekananda spent nearly 2 years lecturing in the cities of Chicago, Detroit, Boston, and New York. By the spring of 1895, his busy and tiring schedule had affected his health. He ended his tours and began giving free private lessons in Vedanta and Yoga. During his visit to the UK in 1895, he met Margaret Elizabeth Noble, an Irish woman who would later become Sister Nivedita. During his second visit to the UK in 1896, he met Max Müller. Apart from these two, Vivekananda had attracted other followers in both the US and Europe, including William James, Josiah Royce, Lord Kelvin, etc. After returning to India on the 1st of May 1896 in Calcutta, Vivekananda founded the Ramakrishna Mission for Social Service. On the 4th of July 1902, Vivekananda awoke early, went to the monastery at Belur Math and meditated for 3 hours. He taught Sanskrit grammar and philosophy of yoga to his pupils, later discussing with colleagues a planned Vedic village in the Ramakrishna Math. At 7 p.m., Vivekananda went to his room asking not to be disturbed, and he died at 9:20 p.m. while meditating.